Hello, hello, my name is Kaiser Anani, and due to the ongoing writer's strike, this is my intro for the week. With me here today is Randy.
Hello.
And Ocelot.
Hello.
And this is Unranked All Pick, and this is Dota 2. So, starting off, we have two teams I don't really know what to make of, you know?
The names on the dire.
Yeah. Both sides, I basically have... Where are you going, Mix? You're not techies. Both people sides have people I can only describe as just like... They could play completely differently, whether depending on whether or not they're playing carry or support in this match. Nix appears to be going solid support, which, I will be fair, he probably should be. Omni-Knight obviously is going to be going support, because carry Omni-Knight is stupid, especially on a team of three carries and one half support. Oracle, probably going to be carry, but Silencer could, like, carry, could, you know, pause four, could, you know, do all kinds of stuff. And at my texture setting, he has, like, a really high definition face, and then his armor is just, like, pixelated in garbage. Look at that.
What the hell is that? Look at Omni's helmet.
That's also true. Jesus Christ.
But Jug looks fine, but that's because Jug is trash.
Owned.
Nix just looks like he has a fine layer of crap on him, like literal
Everybody's
crap.
Everybody's just like in really weird spots. Nothing's gonna come out of here. You know, like we got four down here, but like,
the battle begins.
This is
just
weird.
A silencer. It's
Nix whiffs his stun. Just sits there and has a right click fight with Oracle, because that's gonna work out. Silencer, where are you going, buddy? Silencer does not realize there's anything going on. So that gives us an opportunity to look at lane comp. And of course, like all good teams, we're dual laning mid, because that's not just a meme that people do to show off.
Oh god. This might be a dead Oracle. No, he's got the stun about to be
up. Omni-Knight has not leveled a skill yet. One Purify, he would have been gone.
Good.
So Nix and Omni-Knight appear to be going top. And we got Morana and OD here at bot.
What a lane.
Not a great lane.
This doesn't seem like a... I was going to say, speaking of not a great, I don't think Pudge was a great hero to have in this lineup.
Oh no, that's definitely the case. Especially solo offlane Pudge, as he appears to be here. Doom's in the jungle, obviously, and we got Oracle and Faceless Void for the top lane of the Dire. I will say, these lanes don't look very well set up. I'm just going to say it like it is. These are not very well set up lanes, especially with the fact that they're just like, look at this, they're already trying to just gank mid constantly. It's Silencer. You know, level 1, level 2 Silencer. You might get him. Oh, there's the new Sun
Symbol.
Look,
it's a new update.
Yeah.
Whoa. Great.
But it's gonna be to basically no avail.
Blood for Juggernaut. Great. And Nix dies sooner for Creep.
I will say, to a degree, that was really Silencer's loss there. Just on the grounds, just like, I mean, he saw that there's just one down a bot, and Morana is not a guy who just sits around for too long. Just put well in the way of the creep wave, and then when he heard and saw the arrow, he didn't do a thing about it. Like I said, just definitely more Silencer's loss there for first
Pay
blood
attention.
Than Jug and Morana's victory.
I'd just like to point something out here up at top. Is there just like free farm going up there for this Nix? Like, I don't get
it. It's Nix versus Void and Oracle at top. Oracle's trying to stack and pull, but as you can see here, he's not having much success.
It's not that difficult.
We got, like, fighting going on here. Nix pumps his fake mail for no reason, and Void GG calls it zapping. Omni-Knight has learned what purification is, but sadly, Faceless Void, being Faceless Void, could not give less of a shit.
Don't.
Omni-Knight is not, you know, being very
Pudge
smart
just
here.
Himself.
Pudge just rode himself to death. Nice.
You know, I'm not gonna lie. I almost wish that there was a Troll Warlord on one of these teams, just so I could watch the new stun indicator just go like absolutely horseshit like fast. just constantly getting bashed, boarded to death, or just nothing but a purple bar that keeps getting refreshed because Troll Warlord's bad.
Omni Knight is tiny, yeah. That was way delayed.
Boy, Nyx, gonna get him?
Yeah, both Nyx and Omni Knight are just staying here way too long. Like, it's well time to leave. You're not gonna get both. Oh, maybe you will if you just kind of let some soul die.
Also, I just feel like saying, Omni doesn't really know it right now, more than likely, but Oracle straight counters him because his Purge can get rid of, like, his magic community, his ult, and all that other good stuff.
Yep.
The thing is, though, Oracle's Purge specifically, I believe, since it's not a straight Purge. Straight Purges, like, no damage, no nothing like that, can mess with Omni stuff, but Oracle's, you know, Q in itself is can't target him, but if he hits somebody right next to him, or it just starts it before the magic immunity goes down, that's still a purge, you know. I could be wrong on that, but I believe that's how the case is. It could also just be Oracle can just straight Q him, which will be ridiculous. Because as we all know, there's not enough purges in the game as it stands, because there's only like 6 in every match instead of 10. Looks like we got Doom got ganked in the jungle, but just straight TP'd out. Good on him. Put him behind a little bit, but better than death. Faceless Void. Just
speaking of better than death, this Nyx is facing one if he decides to stay in.
And Void just, like, just can't decide what he really wants to do here. Does he want Oracle? Does he want Omni Knight? Does he want a kill? Does he want to just survive? It's
well,
yeah, it's death.
Rip. Oh,
nope, he barely gets away because Void is really, really fair.
Void barely
sneaks out.
It's time
to leave, buddy.
It's time to cease. Both of these, like, the four at top are all, aside from Oracle, I guess, are all really haphazardous. Like, they are willing to stay in lane at, like, no HP, even when it's death, like, directly in the danger zone. And that could really turn out really poorly for them. For Dire's case, if Morana shows up, and for Radiant's case, if Pudge just makes a fat appearance. Unpopular, but if you're just getting like your ass handed to you in the offlane, you might as well gank. You know, it's not like you're going to be doing anything of value there anyway. If you can't deny and you just can't stay in XP range, you might as well go gank if you can. Chug's phase are finished.
Too bad.
Yeah, Chug's emo phase is finished.
Yep. Now it's only crawling in his skin a little. Omni Knight pings here for no reason. Oracle successfully did this, but it's, Omni. Do the thing, Omni. Do the thing, Omni. Ruin this whole camp for him. Actually, it looks like Nyx is doing the thing. Just ganking, diving as hard as he can.
And dying as hard as he can. Oh, maybe not.
Oh no, it is dying as hard as it can. Silencer here gets it. One end for his trouble. All ones are
well,
breaking.
Time for the cleanup, crew.
Oracle did the thing, and Silencer gets himself another kill. Sitting on 4 in 6 minutes, not bad.
See, Pudge has sort of been sitting here doing nothing, man.
Yeah, Pudge has not been doing a damn thing down here at bot. He's all
Tranquil Pudge!
My gratitude.
You got him.
Now he's fat in jail. Thought about throwing a hook there, decided not to. Hook's gonna miss.
His creeps aren't helping him.
I was really hoping you're just gonna throw a hook at OD there and nab a creep. He still wants
fuck
to
it
do
really.
It. I can tell he still wants to do it, but nothing's gonna come out of it if he does. Even if he lands it.
Yeah, this.
We got 3 top. Morana's here to gank, but.
I was gonna say.
Everybody's just kinda out of the way, so now it's not the time for that. Of the time for that, since we're kind of at a lull here. Just a bunch of things that aren't going to go anywhere. Morana's just going straight for Ag, because you can still just get away with that for some reason. OD, basic items. Oh, bad news for Silencer fans out there. Well, bad news for Jug fans out there, because he's not getting this. Unless he just, like, stops. Pop. Again, one of those classic stalemate battles that just was not going to go anywhere for either team. The prize is mine. Banneron's going down. Yeah, nothing really big shocking here. Even really that fast. Aside from the fact that Morana is just straight going Ags. You know, I'm all for eggs and stuff, but before anything else, Jug might be in trouble, but Silencer's off, so it's not going to be that big of an advantage if he does get him.
God, move out of the way. There we go.
Jug has no time for hooks and only dismembers him after he starts spinning.
Rip.
And he's going to get away with this.
Yep, because Oracle's an idiot and fucking procs his fucking, That's actually a funny way to counter Oracle in certain ways. It's just to, like, have a raindrop and just, like, smack someone with it. It eats all the damage and then just heal back for, like, double. It's pretty great.
Oracle might now be the one in trouble. Yep, Oracle dead.
Rip.
Vague for boardings. For boardings. Vague for boardings now makes sense. Vague forebodings now makes
quick,
sense.
Quick, Neeks, use all of your abilities so you die to this horrible DOT. Is under attack.
Anyway, yeah. This Oracle's play is not impressive so far. He's doing a lot of poor combos. Pudge is like for no reason.
Tried to hook Omni, but
I don't think he tried to hook Omni. I don't think he had like
OD took under 100 damage from Oracle's little purge. Neeks Assassin gets silenced or else he has no time for that. Oh my god, Oracle. Like, don't try to, I know it's popular, right? But don't try to, W and then Q against a team with an Omni Knight. Like, you have to, put down the Burning Flame while the Fortune's End is in mid-flight. Or the Purifying Flame, I'm sorry. While your ball is in mid-flight, or else it's gonna come of it. Rana just denied Neeks. Dyer's bottom was doomed, I suppose. And that's, ult down for another 125 seconds.
Doom's got the, like, the little golem shards, so if he dies, they're gonna just be two mini Dooms.
Doom Jr. Times two. This is not going to turn out very well.
He got one! He finally got one!
Yep, Pudge gets a hook. He hasn't really been going for hooks, I noticed. Like, he made that one on Omni Knight and the one right there, and I haven't really seen him do it otherwise. Then again, I haven't been watching Bot very often in this game, because there's not a lot happening down there as far as kills go. Faceless Void is coming in. Jug runs for his life. If Void switched his treads to, in just one sec- oh, never mind, didn't matter!
Yeah.
Just takes a casual trip right through.
I was gonna say, Void changed his treads to int right there. Just popped Chrono. There's not a lot that Jug can do about it, but
Neeks really wants it.
Let's miss the stun on Void. Let's break his mana, even though he's still got enough for jump, and he's just gonna casually walk away. Not just casually TP.
So we have we have the other update today. The book got brighter.
That's good. Radiant's top tower. Pudge's got OD somewhere. Let's find out. I just ran down bot for him. Omni-Knight's here too, and he can stay if he wants to die. Dyer's middle tower. Yep, there's that brighter book. What a big change. Neeks is having a hard time hitting his ults. I almost have a bad feeling that he thinks it's still unit target. Now he's getting pinged. Dyer's middle tower. By pink, I believe that's Oracle. And well, so, because he's about to get fucked up.
Rip.
Fish, bash, bosh. Oracle doesn't really understand how his purge works as far as the charge time, but Pudge gets a sick hook anyway and it works out.
Dyer's top tower. Well, that was
bit of a slaughter. One unfortunate thing that's happening is that basically all the kills that Dyer's got under their belt right now are happening in the presence of either Pudge or Silencer, sometimes even Pudge. Which is no condition to be in, because, you know, two infinitely scaling heroes. Thank you, Oracle. Purge Pudge.
Purge.
Yep, Pudge, rots through the ball, and that kills Omni Knight, which is an excessively unfortunate way to go.
Pudge smells so bad, you can smell him through multiple dimensions.
I know I can.
Oh,
no, I'm smelling Pudge right now, and let me just tell you, it is not a pleasant odor. Up, OD ruins this arrow.
Rip.
Oracle does this to himself. Neek's assassin just kind of throwing out his mana break a lot, even though it hasn't leveled it very much, so it's not very good. Oracle just keeps purifying stuff for no reason. That was a terrible arrow, but Oracle almost walked into it anyway. And now he's gonna die. Pudge is, or Juggernaut is too, so don't get me wrong. Well, no, maybe Pudge will die for this. Oh, no, Juggernaut is going down. Everybody shuts the fuck up for a moment. Structures are fortified. Another kill down to Pudge.
Oh, God.
Sitting on that 7 jug. Stacks.
Poor fucking Juggernaut.
Oh, just a hook right in the back of the head. Rips the stupid mask off.
Tirana's arrows are not very good today. Up. Neek's got silencer.
Wow, he landed his combo to do absolutely nothing with it. Burnt off a ton of his mana, but like it really matters.
It is silencer. He does have really good regen, especially when he's got 10 soul in at 14 minutes. For these days. Up. Chronos here goes down. Omni Knight follows. Your chronology ends. Fury. Void only is just getting a blast, I notice. His farm is not.
Get him, Neeks! Get him! Get him, Neeks! Your whole team was right there! Come on, man! Get every opportunity as Chrono is down. Here comes the fat man!
Pudge just barely walks past a arrow.
Maybe if I shin my gun.
Are they gonna ult this illusion? Please tell me. Oh, they don't see each other, I don't think.
They do.
Now they do.
Yeah.
Oh no! I'm fat!
Get him!
Ping him!
Get the fat man!
Get the punch! Get the punch!
Get the fat man!
Oh! Carapace!
Get the fat man! Get the fat man! He just gotta kill
someone else! He kills Mirana!
Well...
They got him!
He just gotta kill somewhere else, and he kept chasing the illusion. What the hell? What did he think killed Mirana exactly?
I think that he was pretending to be one of his illusions and mid his auto attack. He just got up to kill, and then he just ult and threw a hook in her face. If I had to make a wild guess, that was a close one.
Dear Pudge, please buy Aetherlens. You better do it.
Always buy Aetherlens on Pudge. Always.
You better do it. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, it's a fast man.
Oh! Doom just got annihilated. Omni Knight accidentally repelled Doom, but it didn't matter.
Oh, Pudge.
Speaking of accidents, Pudge is now wishing that his parents used a condom.
Stack your stumps.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Void just kind of AFK farming down here. He has his Vlads at least, that's good. Just, we're just swarming mid. Nothing can come of this. Oracle is just Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Just bone dry for farm. Even Omni Knight has more. Actually, Omni Knight has less, Dyer's never mind. Both of them are just bone dry. Dyer's middle tower is under attack. Teeth kicked in by OD down here, but I don't think he's gonna really pay for it. Dyer's middle tower. Poor Void. Poor Void.
Well,
easy full stun arrows.
I thought he was about to get doomed, like, somehow by his own teammate, but no, he's just devouring a creep. Like, Void pops in, gets stunned by Neek, gets hit by an arrow, and then doomed by his own team. It's like everyone hates Void.
It's the worst misclick.
Mirana being able to literally jungle with her arrow and so casually is more of a reason why the minimum damage of arrow at almost every level should be lower. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. That's the real issue with Mirana Axe. It isn't even really like the Star Storm in itself, though that doesn't help. It's that Mirana can throw an arrow like 2 feet in front of her face and stun you for 6 hours and do a million damage.
Yep. Dyer's top tower. Not except this time it isn't a bug.
Yeah, I was gonna say, not as bad as back when it literally did max from every range for no reason, but it's almost there. Speaking of almost there, Marana is one item away. Just needs the Blade of Alacrity for her axe.
Yeah, not even the way.
Well, bad news for all those Omni Knight fans out there. He is done.
Oh boy. Buy a teepee, you fool!
Ripped.
And it looks like I was wrong. Oracle's first can direct target people under a bell. I thought you just had to splash him, but no. You can direct target.
Omni Knight is literally fully countered by Oracle.
Oracle, or not Oracle, somebody who's orange being thrown. Sadly, I can't see exactly who because screen shares of appearing as part of the screen, but don't worry, I'll figure it out. Silencer's just like getting chased around a mid by Neeks. And here's up.
Radiance. Well, you have a great perspective on healing.
Wrong place to reveal yourself. My bug. Well,
Pudge just smells really bad at Neeks.
Juggernaut is here. Oh god. Global silence. He can't do a damn thing. And now
Wait, is that just really slow?
And now he's really dead. Another stolen it. More stolen it for Silencer. More fat stacks for Pudge. Could this team be any sadder on the Radiant? Faceless Void casually jungling. He's building himself Deathblade. I approve. Probably my second most pushed item after Octarine Core, if you haven't noticed, is Diffusal Slayer. So being able to knock Oracle junk off of yourself when you don't want it anymore without having MF to purge you. Being able to knock, you know, Omni's stuff off without having Oracle around. I mean, it's just a good item. Silence Surge just eats the butt tier 1 alongside Oracle. So, checking out some charts here. XP decisively favoring the Dire. Team net worth, though, is in favor of the Radiant, curiously enough.
Interesting.
KDA is just almost universally favoring the Dire. Doom and Oracle have not been big contributors to this match, but up to this point, let's be real here, they haven't needed it. Last hits, though, are just solidly Radiant camp. So they've been getting, like, Dire's been winning team fights, but Radiant has been hardcore winning the farm wars. And this meta means that Radiant right now, despite what it looks like, it's still winning for now.
Void might still die.
Zombie's fine.
Nope.
He's just making people suffer the ravages of time, that's all.
Yep. As you do.
Pudge still deciding whether he wants to go in on this or not.
He has the Yules? Why Yules?
I don't know. Forestaff and Yules.
I mean, I guess it's to land an easy hook, but it doesn't do any damage.
Pudge just took the man who's going to kill him. Okay, maybe not. But he's going to get something out of this, no doubt. No? Come on, Jug, ult something! Come on, Jug, ult something! Too late now.
Well,
what are you doing?
Hesitation.
Oh god!
That is fair.
Omni waddles around the fight doing what Omni normally does. Magic immuning and healing everything.
Oh, D is doomed. That's too basic.
Oh god, that arrow.
Marana's axe is complete now.
Good.
Like I said, it doesn't seem like it. But right now, this chart is basically the only thing that matters at this point in the game. Your XP does not.
And the wrecks that are about to fall.
So. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Basically, what matters is that the mid game carry has the farming item he needs. And Manta Style isn't great, but it's good enough. And back with Marana, that basically means that right now, despite appearances. There we go.
Fucking hell.
Remember, you know, I did say last time, you know, don't just use Manta for push, but also do use it for push. Do both. It does both. That's the glory of Manta Style. It's good in combat, it's good for pushing. It does both. Oh, Marana jukes a Oracle Purge. OD gets purged, and then just immediately removed. Doom purges the Magic immunity. Slams him. Purges him again for the slow. He magic sticks. Gets a lot of his health back, but to no avail. Void.
And the one-man chronosphere.
Yep. Not really worth it, honestly. If that were Jogger Marana, maybe that'd be worth it, but on one man chrono on Omni with two, well, three sources of purge on the team, I don't know. So, got a Radiant's little bird down here that had attack. A broken texture background for a Dyer's second when I clicked on it, if you notice. Under attack. Currently, most of
the, born.
Most of the Radiant team is not worrying about this tower here, because they're about to get, they're about to split two towers for the price of one.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Mm.
Well, this could be bad Dyer's for poor Nate.
Top tower is under attack.
Boy jumps in, though to be fair, he doesn't really have anything. Yeah, Pudge goes in for Juggernaut, gets himself killed.
Oh, good.
Yeah, that's kind of the issue with heroes like Jug, Marana. Not so much Neeks or OD, but still to a degree, is that they can get to the point where, you know, even though they're massively underleveled compared to you, just the fact that they have so much more farm means that they still win out anyway.
Yeah, you know, what's a really sad thing about the... I just gotta say this about the Dire team. Doom is a great disable hero, but past that, he's almost worthless these days.
Yeah, he cannot do anything in these fights besides just Doom. And to be fair, his Dooms have been pretty good so far. When he gets a good target, he really, like, it really changes the scope of the fight. But when he doesn't get a good hit, it's not very good.
Yeah, and I just gotta say this. It was actually really smart of him to take that purge off the save tier Banisher, because with the Doom on, with Doom having to go up against an Omni on the enemy team, the consistent low cooldown purge is just brutal.
Not sure why they were going for
really early there. They know they're in rush. Radiant's trying to make the great escape, but whether Pudge or three man chrono.
Oh boy, that hug.
Fresh meat, Neeks is down. On the ults, it's not gonna do all that much. There goes the ults.
Oh, dead.
Jug unintentionally purges the Omni ult off of himself, and Dyer turns around to finish what Radiant started in doing Roche.
Why did they go to Roche? They brought this on themselves.
I think they just assumed that Dyer had no idea they were there, which is never a safe assumption with Roche. Like, even if they don't have any detection, which is not a particularly often scenario, Pudge just slaps Marana on the sideline. Not a particularly common scenario, you still generally have to assume. People in Dota are sometimes smarter than you give them credit for. People will realize that, hey, five people are off the map for no reason, and, you know, we're going ahead, we're getting cocky, we're not getting, you know, ganked for it. They are probably at Roche. You know what I mean? Or, like, they got creeps on their side of the river, nobody is pushing, all five of them are gone, they're probably at Roche. And, of course, the King of the Mall, they just awarded the Roche pin, and then they all went missing, they are probably at Roche.
Yeah. I just like to say, they have a ridiculous amount of wards on the map right now, on a straight line down mid.
Dyer has a this map lit up like a birthday cake. Why it's all down mid, I couldn't tell you, but whatever's happening there, they're gonna know it, I guess.
Picks up,
I guess they just really hate Marana. Speaking of Marana, looks like someone's going into the jungle there. And...
right,
who's who on the Radiant team is in the jungle right now?
That is
Feasiblade.
Lots.
He was on
the
ward too.
Lots and lots of bridge on this game. Well, that might be just why Doom got himself, or Doom Pudge got himself a Yulz here, just for the self.
Yeah.
Just a lot of vision happening right now. Very little of it. Like, I'm pretty sure they can see this ward with that, but they're just not doing anything about it.
Click on it, you can see the radius.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah. Well,
it's
can't
just
see it
like...
well. But I miss the days when they just had a solid circle, if you're a spectator, around the sentry instead of just like a vaguely greener area of effect. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Good old times. Anyway. Neeks finished the thing, and now we can turn to a pile of shit.
A literal pile of shit. A fucking visage flies by. My gaze sees a butthole. That's just it. That's what it sounds like he says, I'm not kidding. Also, looks like we got some action going on at bottom here. Might be a team fight to get
just,
rid of group.
They're about to just gank Void. They're being
unless
really...
they just reveal themselves.
Yeah. Here comes Zero Man.
And he's gonna hit W and fly away. Yep. Nope, Toronto he's gonna hit W and chase this guy down.
Oh, God.
There goes a global silence. They just can't see the Radiant, though, due to Marana's ult. And they're not... They're just looking attack. Around. They can't find him.
Dire's top tower has
found Omni-9, are pinging him, but are just way too far away to do anything. Purge makes Pudge miss. Holds him down. Oh, there goes the magic immunity. There goes Omni-9.
Nyx is just in the general vicinity of this as a pile of shit.
Doom's about to get doomed. Stomps his TP.
Well, now Doom's gonna fuck him up!
Doom reigns, that's all I'm saying.
Or, get him! He's just like, he really wants this.
Oh, God. That he waited so long to start beating up Nyx that OD was able to show up.
Yeah, and it just wore off too, so he's screwed.
Doom needs to get himself an Ags next. I think that's an uncontroversial opinion. Doom Ags is super good. It always has been, it always will.
I remember when Doom had the much higher damage to the Dead these days. That's an interesting choice.
I can see why, given Marana and Nyx, and all the sentries that they have everywhere, it's almost a surprise it wasn't happening earlier, even. So in this downtime, we're going to check the statues real quick. I don't know what Best S. Devora means. I do know what this means. It's nothing, because it doesn't say anything. And, I don't know what Tima Yukbov means. Sorry, that's Tima Yubkov.
I was meant to have this.
Meanwhile, we have Vika. And that's... Oh, Vika and Fly Baby Fly. Hey, that's in English!
And it is zero commands.
Nobody cares about it. Presumably because it's in English in, like the Croatian server or whatever, but... Here we are in sunny seaside Hrvatska, having some fine Dota. Dire can clearly see this Radiant Ward, but refuses to do anything about it. Very strange. Doom cut it down. Owned.
That's great.
Juggernaut is going to get revenge. Maybe not.
No, he won't.
Purge the debuff off of himself because Silencer is a hard hero to deal with. Doom gets a full scale stun.
And the Aegis just went down.
Actually, the Aegis has been down for as long as he's had the gem, I think. Because he had to get that in a slot. Marana just splitting like nothing happening. Nobody can punish her because it's Marana. Doom eats a creep. There is suddenly a lot of downtime in this match.
Yeah, this is getting almost boring even. This is
not
slow.
Worth as tip in favor of the Dire, but not by here we go. Nope. Purge goes downtown and it gets cleared.
Yeah,
disjointed.
Yep.
Invis disjoint. Good.
Everyone's raring for a fight here. Nyx whiffs a stun, gets purged, and silenced for his troubles. Chug just runs right in the middle of the fight, pumps Manta to get rid of the debuff, and then ults, but doesn't do almost a damn thing. Silencer is in a bit of a pickle here. Yep. Luckily, he is hasted. Really need to get rid of that stupid magic immunity on Chug here.
Pudge?
Not in time.
Pudge, no. Oh, that's a really sad
OD. Omni Knight, sooner to follow.
Bopped.
That's three for nothing in favor of the Dire.
He got killed by Void's stupid stock and bopper.
Sadly, the issue that Dire has in fights like that is that they're taking out the wrong guys. The VIPs on the Radiant are Morana and Jug, and they're getting out of basically every fight because they're saving all the dispels for everyone else, basically.
I just gotta ask, what is Void wearing on his hands? They look like sock and boppers. Like, what are those? Oh, they're claws. They look like little green boxing gloves.
Looks like he's like wearing like peppers on the end of his fingers.
Yeah, like jalapenos.
I've been to the Hall of Fenio. Good place.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant structure.
The Hall of Clasherpenio.
There's a glyph.
Juggy's just waiting to fucking ult someone when it comes off cooldown.
Yeah, but he's not gonna get it because Dire have failed to use the time they got in winning the fight. Which is another issue I noticed that Dire have is that they like to get a lot of kills and then just kind of meander around, usually like warding in the downtime. And it's like, yeah, warding's cool during downtime for like one guy to do, not as a team effort. That's when you do it solo.
Yeah.
Void is getting really scary here. He's got Echo Saber, Diff Blade, Manta Style. This is going to be a pretty mean Chronosphere to get hit, but all he needs to do is get some travels and throw some other nice damage item in there, and he's going to be a motherfucker to deal with. Of course, switch to like a satanic late game, obviously, on top of that, but once you got that done, he's going to be a motherfucker
Time
to deal
is
with.
Money.
Time is, in fact, money. It's, by the way. Just in case you're wondering. Void won in Morana there, but another game out of it. Pudge also won in Morana, but once more, nothing comes of it.
And
except their death, maybe.
Miss.
Nope.
Nyx misses a stun every single time.
Yep.
By the way, while this is happening, Joe kills Oracle off screen.
He did some skilled.
Wrecked.
Nyx buried himself. Morana's just in the trees now.
Yep, Jug just straight right-clicked two people up here to death. Actually, I think
Omni,
but... because
Juggernaut is a cool hero.
God.
Nyx gets buried in the mound of shit. Nobody notices. Doom's still on that gem? He sure does. Building something with this plate, I assume probably AC. Not entirely impossible as Lotus, but I kinda doubt it. Yeah, Void. Nope, too late now. Time to fuck off. Oh, here comes the fat man. And that doesn't work, it seems.
Miss!
I got him, I just don't think Hook can hit bro targets, can it?
I'm pretty sure it can.
Because it just, like, passed right over him.
Yeah.
I
Maybe
think that was
just
a camera thing.
Stupid hitbox, you never know. In fact, given the nature of things like this in Dota, I'm going to go ahead and go on a limb and say it's probably just a stupid hitbox issue. Well, you got to get some smoke, because what you really want to do is you want to smoke up when you can't see anyone on the enemy team.
Yeah, that's great.
Yep, and then somebody pink just scribbles out the entire top half of the map. They have no time for this garbage. And Morana, the only person that they had any sort of idea where she was, is just gone. It's okay, though, because we're going right here to die to Jug. Void! Do something! The perfect guy! If you want to solo chrono anyone, it's Jug.
Yeah.
And I think he got, like, Oracle ulted for that, too. Oh, no, he didn't. Okay. Come on, though. Seriously. Nyx just still right
at hesitation.
Basically, if you have a teamfight ult and there's a Jug on the enemy team who is being the position one, it is completely fine to just blow straight on him. Because he's such a slippery motherfucker to actually catch, especially with his magic immunity, that you basically are going to want to do it. You don't have much of a reason not to do so. So that smoke was completely pointless, and Jug has to, Void has to juggle the courier to get his stuff back. Fat Man's finished some blade mail. He definitely doesn't need it, to say the least. He definitely does not need that stuff. And now Dire.
Hey, you know what's about the same?
Is it the Aether Lens?
Yeah.
Is it
Nyx's? You should have literally gotten Aether Lens, like, second item, pretty much.
You always should. It's basically inexcusable not to have it on budget at this point. Like, Aetherlands and Nags. Everybody is silent. Nyx just dies like a bitch. And Pudgy's just hesitating hardcore on getting Omni for some reason.
Speaking of a bitch.
Doesn't
Hedge
matter,
commune.
Though, he just dies.
Purrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
Great. We're on a rat's top because at this point Radiant can just straight afford to have, you know, sub 5 in a fight. Now she's coming to rat bot. Nobody's ever going to be able to do anything about her. Unless they have global silence and drop it for her alone, which is not worth it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Oh!
Well. Well.
Oh,
what?
No!
What? Chrono? Chrono OD? Don't chrono this guy! Don't chrono the threat on their team, the man who can single-handedly win games. Chrono OD. Alright.
I guess he didn't want to risk, like, Jug just flying in, but unfortunately that would require you to actually hit him with it. And killing all your teammates.
No, I assume it was because he didn't want OD to just ult the second he got out of the ball, which wasn't going to do very much anyway because he hasn't stolen any int. And his items are not, yeah, they're not exactly int city, to say the least. Jug has himself a full Scotty now, he's just a nightmare. Still refuses to pop Manta style for anything but the dispel, which, you know, you'd think you'd just buy it or use the, oh, there we go. Sending ghost armies in.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Dire's getting mid, but they're gonna lose two sets of racks for it. There's not a lot they can do about it. Unfortunately for Pudge, blade mailing Omni Slash does not in fact work.
Yep.
It needs to, honestly. It needs to.
Oracle had to back, so he left Pudge for that. Yeah, I'm gonna say that was on Oracle for just, like, completely abandoning Pudge to go and try and die to Mirana.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
They did get the melee racks here at mid for it, though. Silencer.
Don't mind him, he's just collecting reports. Every time you kill a creep, you get reported. Speaking of...
dead.
Creep.
Completely pointless.
Oh, here comes the. He has a gem. You.
Doesn't matter because she has a blink.
I was gonna say on mine. It looks like she blinked out of the map. I was like, on honest to God on my end, like she wasn't even facing the direction she blinked in. It just looked like she just instantaneously just left the map. Like nope.
Looks like Void wasted his chronosphere on something again.
Oh, God.
Yeah, this is about all said and done. Neek's got the godlike, but it's not like he can't use the money, you know? Everyone smokes for no reason, and only Mirana and Omni-Knight here care about it. Everybody wants to gank that ward. For whatever reason. Ah! Yeah, ult it. Fresh meat. Boy, he buys back, it's just too late.
Get him!
Radiant, what are you
get
doing?
Get
him! Oh, it's a classic case of I am able to rat, so I literally have to do it
Pudge,
all the time.
Hit your ult, it reveals invisible people, my god.
I have the ability to rat, so I can literally never be with my team at any point, even when they really need me. The movie. It's okay though, Mirana was jungling.
God.
And Jug was just sending more ghost armies after the top tier 3 here.
Top tower is under
to be fair, at least they're probably gonna get it. Please do one of these. Yep.
Top tower has fallen.
Loses half of his mana to Jug Illusion,
meanwhile,
that's pretty good.
Mirana almost got bought racks here. I don't know where exactly she expects to go. To hell, maybe. Yep. Dire just lost his lot of range. Not a huge deal, but definitely can add up. Juggernaut just knocked out Oracle, who was here for some reason. I wish I could tell you what he was doing here, but I can't. Somebody, they are fighting hardcore over this courier. I see Void and Oracle and all kinds of people.
Dire's courier.
Just going apeshit on it. And it has Void's full maelstrom. Oh, I see. Fucking Oracle is feeding at this point. That's good.
Oh, that's just wonderful.
If only I could report as a spectator. Fed his life, fed the courier. Full maelstrom on it, by the way. Could have been game-changing, but, you know, I'm a meme. I'm a fucking idiot who gets really mad the first time I die. But I don't even do anything conductive with the rage, I just start feeding like a bitch. Oh, Omni Knight gets grease and some smoke, because what you want to do is you want to smoke when you can't see anyone on the map.
Oh yeah, that's a great plan.
Pro
It'll
tip.
Always work out.
When you smoke when you know the enemies where you know the enemies are and generally know where they're about to go. You don't just smoke for fun. You don't just smoke because the pros do it and you want to look cool. You smoke with it for a purpose. It's, you know, it is an expensive habit, not on an individual basis, but it adds up. And as we all know, smoking kills. So, if you're going to smoke, smoke when you see people. Not even when you guess there's people there. Smoke when you see people. That's it. Period. So, Marana, just warning. Oracle is losing a fight with a single drug illusion. Fresh meat. Poof. Well, Mid gets funged down. Marana is just top. Just gonna murder this Rax. Well, she's just gonna camp out here until she can murder this Rax. Of course, the Dire are going to fall for this, and every single one of them is going to go all the way back to the ranks for this, even though it's a easily dealt with scenario. And, yep, just TP's out before anyone can do anything about it. Are you shocked? Because I'm not. You can't waste your time with things like this. Like, when you have somebody who's ratting you, you gotta respond with exactly enough force. Because if you just throw too much out there and nothing comes of it, then you've just wasted a lot of time for a lot of people, you know? It's part of the entire theory of just measured response.
God, this is just sad to watch. It's just
If you boys were at Carl von Clausewitz, you would know this. Oh, Doom is about to get missed by the arrow.
Massively overshotted.
Does not matter.
Apparently hit Void! The arrow hit Void in the middle of nowhere.
Good. And Radiant just TP's out.
Had Void not gotten hit by that arrow, he would have been able to kill at least one or two of those guys with Chrono. Oh, that accidental save.
And now he's actually calling in the courier, and this time Oracle seems to be enough of not a bitch to,
not feed it to the enemy.
Yep. Oracle's trying to call for Roche, but he's not there, so he'll just have to wait. You know, there's a script nowadays that actually exactly... Well, boy, it's just fucking... Juggernaut is just murdering here. And everybody goes for the illusion. Up. We might see Jug die here.
And... dead!
Drug actually goes down. It's only a wicked sick, and it goes to Doom, but that could still be big. If they make good use of this time, especially considering that they did not drop Chrono or False Promise during this, if they make good use of this time, they could win the game right now.
Ooh.
Unfortunately, Oracle can just get removed from the game.
Oh boy.
Neek's just straight TP's out. Silencer cannot do a thing about it.
Silencer himself needs to get a disable. I think he needs to go for a scythe, honestly.
It's gonna be a while for him, though. Well, he does have a moon
shard. Not that far off. Maybe he can just eat the moon shard and go straight forward.
A lot behind where he actually was. Just take a quick curve.
He's got, like...
How much stolen does he have? Like fucking 20, 30?
Blue. Look at all these blue and purple items. Almost everything anyone has.
Blurple. Oh god, void!
Everybody's just trying to create their own void. That's basically what's happening here. Bad news for any Pudge fans out there in the audience.
Yeah, it's like those weird, like, shrinking things, whatever they were, those old toys you'd see in, like, dollar stores. It's just like, grow your own this or that.
Yeah, grow your own...
Just grow your own void.
Nix, do it. Money. Your invis is gonna run out anyway, man. Just do it. Just do it!
Do it!
Just do it! What are you doing? What are you doing? I gotta get the void, cause that's the kill I'm gonna get.
Yeah, you're gonna hit him once. I remember back in the day when Void still had his goddamn random chance for damage evasion, yeah. And he could just literally a full Nyx combo and just take no damage. And two Zeus ults? Yeah, you wish. All because RNG decided to shit in your cornflakes. Man, I almost missed that, but I don't.
It was funny, but a terrible thing to have happen to you.
At least it didn't actually, like, nullify the effects, like the stuns and stuff. If it did that, it would have been broken also. Doom gets caught up on tree!
And then just gets destroyed!
Well...
Global silence goes out.
I'm 90% sure he's dead. Oh, like 3 HP. Jug is dead again! You become past tense. Oh.
But Doom dies and Nyx gets the gem. Does not
no,
get
he
out.
Though. He's just gonna bury himself in the dirt. Oh, they have sentries this time.
Well, it looks like somebody else might have gotten away with the gem. Let's find out. It was Silencer. Meanwhile, this is happening.
Murata! Oh my god! Void runs the wrong way! Murata's cooldowns are all held off by, time dilation.
Wouldn't it be funny if one of those, Maelstrom zaps just, like, got her? Oracle saves you. I wouldn't doubt it. I haven't been watching Zagloss purifying for a long time, but...
Odie's about to get re-murdered. Oh, boy! Oh, he's gonna get away. Oh, God!
Instead.
Good lord.
Oh, Void really wants this.
The secret that people don't know about Void nowadays is that Blink Dagger is not an option. You are just too slow. And your jump is not enough to get around anymore.
Yeah, it's only like 600 distance, isn't it? It's got a decent cooldown, but it's just not enough. You need either a good move speed or a blink.
Yep, yep, and this Void right now has neither. Coming down to get the Radiant Ranger Tracks here. I don't believe this is going to go over very well for them.
Radiant's
unless Murata simply declines to do anything here, and she's already acting. Get the racks.
Radiant's middle barracks has fallen.
Void is going apeshit. Like, up. Juggernaut just ruins two people, three on the enemy team. Pudge, Oracle, and Silencer just got erased. Void falls. Unkind.
Sometimes you just need to drop a chrono to get away, you know?
Okay,
and that was one of those times.
Doom was here. I gotta say, Omni Knight and Oracle were just pretty bad picks this game for both of them. Like, Oracle has a lot of assists, but that's basically just from the fact that he's been at fights, unless from him doing anything at them, you know? Many, many, many times. It's just simply been a case of Oracle saving belonging.
My god, the murder that is going on right now.
Yep,
two buybacks.
This is the point in the game where the actual, like, decently farmed carries can take somebody from full to nothing in nearly no time at all. And right now, unfortunately for the Dire, Radiant has two of those in Jungle Murata, and Dire just has Void.
You know, it just dawned on me that Omni is 0, 12, and 6.
Yeah, he's not doing so hot, to say the least. Like I said, like, basically, he's a wasted slot, but sadly for the Dire, Oracle is as well.
I was meant to have this.
If you catch my drift. Like, they basically spent him as a counterpick to Omni Knight, and they didn't need him. They really didn't need him. They have so much purge already, they could have easily got more. Silencer could have easily gotten away with the diff this game. I'm sure Doom probably wouldn't have been able to black one either to go alongside his existing purge. Silencer bought a second gem for his team, unless they're lacking the first one. Yeah, Mirana apparently ended up with the first one. OD finishes up a Scythe of Ice. Silencer just got a that gem off the courier. Mirana jukes by a leap. Neek's Assassin just kind of sits here and watches Void farm. Oracle just vanishes. Not even for an Omni Slash. Void is just sitting here with no mana. Unfortunately for the poor Neek's Assassin, an untimely Silencer arrival spells his death.
Dire, I can only imagine what's going to happen in this team fight. Are they going to defend the rocks? They're just going to let it fall.
No, they're just going to go, like, group up in the secret shop and team farm this one camp for some reason.
Party.
That's all that came out of this. I make no exaggeration, that's all that just came out of that. What the fuck? Team Jungle. Everyone get in the secret shop and here, let me form this one camp. Pudge finishes the axe he should have gotten like a million years ago. May your doom be averted. He still doesn't need, like, you don't need all three of these items. You could really get away with selling one. Or honestly, two. Like, for me, you know, this is a little bit unorthodox for Pudge, I know, these days, but for me, it's either Blink or Force or Yules. Up. There we go. For me, as I was saying before a little bit of lag spike happened, it's Blink or Force or Yules. It's not all of them at the same time, most certainly.
Riddle me this. What do you think is going
to
happen when Mirana gets up to someone with that E-Blade Dagon 5 Axe combo? Like, say, the enemy Void.
It's gonna hurt.
Yeah. They will die.
But the issue is she needs to just do it, you know?
Yeah, I would laugh if Void bought just, like, a spontaneous blade mail.
Like, Mirana is really scaredy here. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but she's just, like, avoiding as much conflict as she can to try and just go through simply, you know, split pushing, just occasional pickoffs. That's it. Even Jugs and Illusions are getting really hard to kill. Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Void, who are you? Void beats up OD.
No, that was a Neeks. Oh, Jug is dead! Oh.
Silence,
he has buyback, he's up! Oh my god!
Omni Slash, but to...
Silencer's down! Pudge is about to follow suit? No.
They smoke. What an appropriate time for this.
Yeah.
Oh, they are going straight for Void. Oh,
just
my god.
Boom. Rip.
And
that's the game.
That might actually be the game. They have enough damage to clear these. Don't even bop back for that. Oh, no. Oh.
Chuck here's not for your foolish moral rack. He's just going straight to the ground and you can stop him. This is just a case of bad priority on the Dire nearly this whole game, I think. Just, especially, I hate to say it, on Void, just being really hesitant to drop Chronos aside from either, like, it's a weird economy here, right? Void only dropped Chronospheres for kills he could get without them, or for, like, people he was Jugger commended, people he was not going to, like, get at all. Trying to get, like, four people in a Chronosphere at once and ending up with, like, Omni Knight, you know? So you either just blew it or oversaved it. It's just not a good middle to have. It would be perfectly fine in this game to have just basically dropped and focused Jug in every chrono. Because Jug's just that kind of hero right now. When you got a hero who can just jump off the map and still kill your team without being touchable, it's perfectly fine to respond to him with that kind of resistance, especially when his mantle lets him get rid of basically anything that else seems to be dropped on him. Same goes for Mirana, really. Both sides of that exchange were just really hasn't do anything to each other, but in particular, Void was really just not very... And when he did Chrono, he usually went for OD. I don't know why. Like, OD, especially this game, was just nowhere close to the threat of Juggernaut. So, I don't understand what Void was thinking. A lot of the global silences weren't very good either. So, I guess we'll just end this up with a one-sentence summary for everyone. And unlike most times, I really genuinely have something to say for everyone here. Neek's Assassin, use your ultimate. It's not just invis, you know? A lot of times, just strictly hesitated to take Void, straight hesitated to take Pudge, straight hesitated to take people that he could have easily gotten into. Just kept wandering around with it, especially bad once they started picking up gems and detection, because, you know, he would just get caught out and beaten up every time he would just try to pull that. Even if you get found in Invis, you can still use your first strike out from it. It's perfectly fine. It still works, even if you get caught, you know? It's not like a Broodmother thing where you get beat up and it just drops. OD, use your goddamn ult. I know I just said that for Neeks, but at least for him, it was use in the sense of make some use out of it. For OD, it's actually use it. Did you guys see him ult one time through this game?
I don't think I did.
Ocelot?
You know, if I really had to say about this game, I think that the Dire made one fatal mistake.
That's not whether or not OD has ulted. That can be in the closing comment.
And I don't care. I just gotta say that Dire had entirely overcommitted to the idea of countering Omni. Doom carried the Save Tier Banishment buff for the longest time in the game when they could have used something a bit more substantial, like, say, the Dire Wolf Aura.
That's definitely true, but did you see OD ult at any point this game?
I think I saw him ult once, and that was about 20-something minutes, I think, was a fight near the bottom tier 1.
I mean, I don't even remember that much. I didn't see him ult a single time. Mirana, you can't be scared. If you've got E-Blade and Dagon and Ags, you can't be scared. It's just as simple as that. You can't just commit to ratting. You can't just commit to getting pickoffs. There are times when you have to put on your big boy pants and actually be in a team fight. There were several times where your team was on the brink, on the ropes. Dire didn't really take much advantage of it, I'll get to that. On the ropes. But you just, like, just went to rat when your team was having a big fight. Just went to rat when your team needed you, most of all. There were some times where it worked out in your favor, where, like, Dire would drop everything to try and go get you when you weren't even really a priority, or when one person would do. Probably one of their... I'd say their second big mistake is that Dire, like, tried to respond to everything with 5-man, and even in this meta, that's not how you do it. Juggernaut, just... You gotta use your active items. You gotta use them a lot more. He was decent enough on using his purges, but for a game this long, he only barely got into those Div 2 purges. Very rarely used Mantis style except to self-purge, and he was really bad about using it for push. Aside from that, nothing I could really say because, you know, a monkey could play Jug well. Let's just be real here. It's not a very high skill ceiling, to say the least. Omni Knight... I can't even really describe what I'm about to say in a single sentence, so I'll just say this much. Be aware of your counters and build to deal with them. If you had, honestly... Well, for starters, if you've been a lot quicker on the draw, you could have gone a lot with Purification this game. You stayed almost exclusively on just Repel in your ult, which did not work against a team with, you know, 4 purges, basically. When you're Omni Knight, you gotta be smart about using that Purification. You gotta be smart about dropping the bomb. Most importantly, you gotta be smart at saying, well, I could be accidentally stealing a kill here, but it might also not be secure. The number one most important thing with a kill is not who gets it, but that it happens. After all, if you're saving a kill, if you're saving a last hit for Jug or OD, and they don't get it, it's just a net loss, you know? If no one gets a kill, it's just a net loss. And if he goes quicker on the gun on that, maybe even got himself a couple of kills, he could have easily had maybe a Lincoln's or a Lotus this game, which would have basically completely solved his counter problem. Oracle, learn how to play Oracle. I'm sorry, it's mean to say, it's just simply how it goes. Learn how to play Oracle. You could purge right, everything else was just bad. You purified and saved a lot of enemies on a lot of occasions, and you had a really nasty habit of playing into Omni Knight, ironically, by purifying somebody after your ball was down, and then they just got, you know, magic immune, and so, you know, no damage could come out of it. You couldn't purge it back off very easily, you know, they just got to heal. You know? Very, very, very important that you don't just let your enemies heal off everything you do. Very, very important that you stay consistently focused, and make sure also that you don't accidentally drop your little no melee attack modifier on a friendly whenever they need to auto attack, which is why it's not generally a good idea to do it on somebody like Void unless he's already running away. Silencer, be smarter about your ult. Unlike Neek's assassin, who didn't use his ult very well, and OD, who didn't use his ult at all, you used your ult too much. Like, it's a weird thing to say, but it really did feel like Silencer just ulted the second he saw an enemy and the second it was off cooldown, you know? And a lot of times, global silence isn't so much a question of, like, whether or not you do it, but when you do it. If you get a good global silence off at a good time, preferably, what you want to do is you want to sweet spot it like you do with any global skill like that, and get it right in the smack dab center of a fight. You know, when everybody's in and everybody's invested, but they haven't blown everything they have, and you haven't lost the fight yet, then that's when you global silence, when they're committed to it. Because a lot of times what would happen is Silencer would just blow his ult on, like, Jug walking up to him, and then Jug would just turn around, walk right back away, wait for it to end, and then just go right back in and kill people, you know?
Yep. Would have been over in a literal instant. Also, so much Blink Dagger reliance.
Yeah, if anybody on really either team, but especially the Radiant, got a Radiance this game, now fitting, that would have been a really, really, really bad thing for the Dire, who almost all rely on Blinks for mobility. Except, ironically, maybe the guy who relies on Blink for mobility the most. Well, that's not true. Silencer relies on it for mobility the most, but Void's a close second. So, Void. Smarter chrono use. Again, very many big ults this game, if you couldn't notice. You know, very big ult issues this game. You have to be good with chronosphere. Unlike, you know, OD, who still got carried through this game without using his ult. Unlike Neex, who can use his ult just for the invis, even if he doesn't do it. Both cases is not ideal, not effective, but better than nothing. You have to use your ult right. You cannot get away as Faceless Void if you drop a chrono on the wrong guy all the time, if you just go for the wrong guy within the chrono all the time, and worst of all, if you chrono your teammates all the time. Now, you were really good at not doing that last thing, but the other two, you had real big problems with it. I don't know what the fire in Void's eyes was for OD and Omni Knight, but basically every time a chrono went down, it was on one of those two, and he usually got the kill for it, but he needed it for Jug, he needed it for Mirana, and he basically shouldn't have used it on anyone else. It might be shorter cooldown, especially if you get Ags. You didn't, but especially if you get Ags, I wouldn't recommend it here anyway. A lot shorter cooldown than something like Black Hole or Ravage or something like that, but you have to think about it in that same vein. You can't, it's not something you just throw away. It's not something you can just casually toss out. It has to be well planned, well used. Pudge.
Now, if I may just...
Okay, go on.
Yeah, I was gonna say, if I may just say about the Pudge, I think I can sum it up, it's straight up. He built all the wrong items at the wrong times. Mm-hmm. He built Tranks for starters. Like, don't get me wrong, in some lanes you may want to get Tranks if you're against a heavy amount of harass. 9 times out of 10, you really don't, though. 9 times out of 10, you really don't.
Hey, it's not me complaining about the Tranks this time.
And on top of that, he needed a damn Aether Lens, and he did not get it, ever. Ever, at any point did he get that Aether Lens.
Got the eggs way too late for it to really mean anything, too. He got
hell, he missed a handful of hooks just because he didn't have Aether Lens.
And a lot of opportunities to get them on that ground. Like, the biggest issue Pudge had is just his items were awful. It's just garbage. Let's be real here. You don't need three mobility items as Pudge. Usually, you can get away with just Force Staff. If you're having some, you know, if you need a lot of mobility, you can get Force and Blink. I don't think I would ever take Yules aside from a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and this sure wasn't it. And the Blade Mail, just like, I understand why he get it. He did get it because he was on a, you know, HP fat team. But the issue is that the big reason he got it, which was Romney Slash, well, guess what? It doesn't work during that. Blade Mail does not do anything to Juggernaut. And by the time he got it, it was late enough that Jug was so much more tanky than him, even with his, you know, 27 stacks of fat, that even if he did Blade Mail, it still really wouldn't have mattered all that much. Needed an Aether Lens. Needed something more substantive than that Blade Mail. I think a Pipe of Insight would have been fantastic on him, just to stand up to Mirana's constant star barrages, stand up to Odie if he ever decided to use his ult, stand up to Nyx's blast, and of course stand up to his own rot, which did really mess him up a lot of times in fights. Like, Pipe is great on Pudge, especially nowadays, because it basically lets you just straight rot forever, as long as you want, if you're at any decent amount of fat stacks. Finally, Doom. You just gotta get better farm. Like, I hate to say it. It's such a, you know, a straight thing to say. But there are some times when you say, okay, Oracle, I know you want your Glimmer Cape. Silencer, I know you want your Rod of Atos and Moonshard, but I need money. And sure, yeah, he did have AC and Shiva's, and both of those are pretty big ticket items. But as a hero like Doom, you need your Ags. You basically want either a Refresher or Octarine, probably both, and then you still want items to accoutrement that, right? And this game, Doom didn't even get close to that measure. As a walking ult, you know, he does need those items. It's just simply almost direct fact. And so many times in this game, so many times, it was hard to count. Doom could have had his teamfight, like, won. If he had an Ags, all he needed, he just needed that Ags, he could have just doomed Juggernaut and just hugged him for the rest of the team fight, and the fight would have been won. Even if Jug didn't die, it would at least be so long that all of his team would be down and he'd have to slink off away. So,
with that all being said then, I'd like to make my Sag Clown of the Game proclamation.
Oh boy, let's hear it.
Now, you'd think it would be Omni, but no. Omni got what he asked for by picking Omni. Honestly, the most just sad son of a bitch this game had to be this Nyx. Everywhere he went trying to get pickoffs, he would just miss his stun 9 times out of 10. He would get completely just... He would get detected out of the ground with sentries and dust and everything. Like, if you look over on the right there, look at the Radiant kill count with just Nyx being, like, the lineup for that. This Nyx, and more Nyx.
Yep.
Look at that.
And a lot of times, too, even when that wasn't the case, he eventually just got so damn... Why did Chuck level the last two levels of his ult until near 25?
That wasn't his ult, that's his crit. Why?
His crit. His ridiculous crit. You know, I don't want 35% crit chance until level 25, even though that's statistically better DPS than PAs. It's ridiculous, it really is. Yeah, Nyx, definitely. But if I had to say the Sad Clown of the Game Award, I would say it would be Oracle. Just like, he might have a lot of assists, but like I said, that was just by proxy of just being in these fights and kind of tapping people with his AoE. If it was, like, if assists were more fair, he would be something like 3-9-7, to be real with you here. I mean, he just didn't do a lot. Whenever he did, you might as well have played Groose's theme in the background for how incompetent he was.
So, feed the courier.
Just Bulk and Skull playing in a big ass speaker while he just goes and does his business.
So, closing comments, Randy.
Shadows, take us.
Ocelot?
Please, for the love of God, buy Aether Lens on Pudge!
You have no excuse not to.